हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई तुषार पटेल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम द कॉलेज महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी, वुड लाइक यू टू वेलकम ऑल फॉर द न्यू सब्जेक्ट कोर्स ऑफ हार्बर एंड एयरपोर्ट इंजीनियरिंग. बिफोर आई प्रोसीड टूवर्ड्स द टॉपिक फॉर टूडेज लेक्चर, I'd like to quote a phrase said by Mahatma Gandhiji. Live as if you were to die tomorrow. Learn as if you were to live forever. Meaning, it's important to seize the day, but always make time to go deeper and wider in your learning. So, my dear friends, today I'll give you a brief introduction to the harbor engineering. So, today's contents will be introduction to water transportation, its advantages and disadvantages. Then I'd like you to move and think about the difference between harbor and a port, their classification. And the last thing for today's topic would be the major ports in India. So, as we all know, waterways have different historic importance in the development of civilization and in the growth of nation. Ancient people utilized rivers and seas as their first facility for mass transportation of goods. It was only on rivers, lakes, and seas that heavy loads such as timber, stone, food grains could be carried in large quantities. Only light, valuable goods were sent over long distances by land. Hence, we say that water transportation can be a good concern with the conveyance of people and goods in the vehicles that float upon water. So, waterways can be classified broadly into two: oceanic waterways and inland waterways. Oceanic waterways. These are concerned with the conveyance of people and goods primarily across the oceans between continents or islands. Whereas inland waterways consists of water transportation on rivers, lakes, canals within the mainland, within the territory of any country. In India, river transportation became popular in 1855. Near about 65,600 kilometers, we have a total perennial waterways that is located in India, out of which 41,600 kilometers are rivers and 24,000 kilometers are canals. Let us move across to the advantages of water transportation. As we all know, around the world, 82% of the international trade in tons and 94% of the world trade in ton kilometers are moved by shipping and thereby through ports. So, there are many advantages for water transportation facilities. Some of them are here. Requires cheap manual, wind and steam motive power. They are able to carry higher load capacity for bulky and heavy commodities. Development of commerce and expansion of trade. Development of agriculture. Water transportation is the easiest and the cheapest mode of communication. Water transportation helps in the development of industries and the nearby areas. These also help in the development of natural resources and the effective use. Through water transportation, the discovery of new islands are possible. In today's economic world, the water transportation helps in the development of the economic progress and international contact with them to trade. It also assists in the problem of national defense. Now, let us have a glance of the disadvantages of water transportation. It requires more time due to slow speed. Many a times, the mountainous rivers and waterfalls hinder the water transportation. They require better positioning and obstruction detecting systems to avoid surface collisions. Due to the frequent storms in the water, there may be a great loss of life and material. With the rapid growth in demand, which is more than the capacity existing facilities. Many a times, the vessel oil spillage, noise, smoke, and the fumes causes pollution and endanger the marine lives. Uncertainty problems such as energy shortage, problems due to political and natural causes may hamper the water transportation. The energy conservation concerns because of energy problems of the transportation development. So, my dear friends, now we move across to the definitions of harbor and a port. Harbor, it is partly enclosed area which provides safe and suitable accommodation for supplies, refueling, repair, loading and unloading cargo. Whereas a port is a harbor where marine terminal facilities are provided. So, a port can be stated or defined as harbor plus the storage facility plus the communication facility and the other terminal facilities. So, from the above definitions, it can be stated that a port includes a harbor. That is, every port is a harbor. Next, we move across to the classification of harbor. Harbor can be classified according to the three basic priorities: protection needed, utility, and location. Classification based on protection needed may be classified as natural harbor, semi-natural harbor, and artificial harbor. Classification based on utility may be divided as commercial harbor, refugee harbor, military harbor, and fishing harbor. And classification based on location may be divided as ocean harbor, river harbor, canal harbor, and lake harbor. So, let us understand what is a natural harbor. The term indicates that the harbor that is formed naturally by the protection of mountains, bays, islands, and are used since a long time. So, by looking at the figure, we can say that every harbor which is situated in between any of the mountainous areas, bays or islands may be termed as natural harbor. The advantages of natural harbor is that in case of development, right, where there is a natural harbor, the nearby development of the population, graphical features, etc. are rapid. Next, the semi-natural harbor. As we can see in the figure, one side it is protected by the mountainous area and the second side it is protected by a breakwater. So, the semi-natural harbors are formed naturally, but sometimes at the harbor entrance, man-made constructions are required for some protection against the winds and the waves. Artificial harbor. Artificial harbors are the man-made harbors that does not contain any natural protection. These protections are built artificially, which are called as breakwaters. Now, what is breakwater? These are the structures which prevent the inside water from storms and waves and keep the inside water still. Classification based on utility. First one is the commercial harbor. The commercial harbors are those where loading and unloading of the cargoes are done. Some of the commercial harbors are limited to loading and unloading of single commodity like coal, crude oil, petroleum, etc. The repair works can also be carried out here, but they should be quick. Refugee harbor. A large area harbors which are useful to the shelter the ships during emergency situation like storm or any other natural calamity. Harbors of refugee are constructed with large entrance and they are easily accessible. They provide good anchorage to the vessels against storms and tide. Military harbor. The harbor that are used as naval bases, where warships are rested while there is no work in the sea or during repair works. Some large military naval vessels can carry aircraft, so very large area of harbor is required because of large vessels. And the last one, classification based on utility, is our fishing harbor. Now the term itself states and the figure itself shows you what a fishing harbor may look like. Fishing harbors are specially meant to cargo carrying seafood or aquatic animals. They are always open to fishing ships for loading and unloading. For preserving the seafood, sufficient space is provided near the harbor. Next, classification based on the location. So the first classification is ocean harbor. The harbor that is situated along the seashore is termed as the ocean harbor. Second, we move across to the river harbor. The harbors that are constructed in the rivers, which finally connects the sea. These are a form of navigation inside a country for non-coastal areas. Next, canal harbor. These are also similar to the river harbors, but a canal is connected to the sea through a major river. Last but not the least, lake harbor. The lake harbor that is situated along a seashore is termed as a lake harbor. After the classification of harbor, now we move across to the classification of ports. Ports can be classified as the following four: ocean port, river port, entry port, and free port. As its definition says, ocean port can be defined as a port intended for large ocean going ships. These are situated in the oceanic bodies. Next, river port. River port is located on the banks of the river inside the land. These are used for the navigation for the inland in the mainland. Entry port. This is a location where foreign and citizens and goods are cleared through custom houses. And lastly, free port. This is an isolated and enclosed area within which goods may be landed, stored, mixed, repacked, manufactured and reshipped without the payment of duties. So now we come to the list of all the major ports in India. The map in front of you shows the 13 major ports that are present in the country, starting with the port situated in Gujarat, Kandla Port. Port situated in West Mumbai, Maharashtra, Mumbai Port. The third one is the port situated in South Mumbai, Maharashtra, Jawaharlal Nehru Port. Next, Panaji, Goa. Murmagao port. Then we move across to Karnataka in the city of Mangalore, the new Mangalore port. Next, Kerala, the city known as Kochi. Then we have the Kochi port. In the state Tamil Nadu, in the city of Tuticorin, Tuticorin port. The more specific thing in Tamil Nadu, Tamil Nadu consists three of the ports. The second of them, it's located in Chennai, known as Chennai port. And the third, it is also located in Ennore, Ennore port, Karmarja port. The next port situated in the state Andhra Pradesh, that is Visakhapatnam port. In the state of Odisha, in the city of Jagatsinghpur, the port of Paradip. In the state Kolkata, in the city West Bengal, Kolkata and Haldia port. And last but not the least, in the Union Territory, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, we have the Port Blair port. So, India, having a vast coastline of about 7,400 kilometers, are served by our 13 major ports and about 184 minor ports and private ports. The major ports are those ports which are under the purview of the central government, and the minor ports are also known as non-major ports. However, out of the 185 minor ports, 61 of them provide round-the-year berthing facilities. So, let us study a significance of each and every port that is situated in India. First, Kandla port. It is located in the state Gujarat. It is also known as the growth engine of India and hosts the major seaport of the west coast. The port of Kandla is the first special economic zone in India as well as in Asia. The major imports of the ports are petroleum, chemicals and iron. And the major exports are grains, salt and textiles. The port of Kandla is one of the highest earning ports of India. Next, we move across to the Jawaharlal Nehru port situated in Maharashtra. It is also known as Navasheva. The Nehru port is situated at the mainland of Konkan area across the Navi Mumbai, Maharashtra. It is the largest container port in India. Jawaharlal Nehru is the king port of Arabian Sea at the west coast. The major exports are textile, carpet, boneless meat, and the imports are machineries, vegetable oils and chemicals. Mumbai port, Maharashtra. The Mumbai port is located in the mainland of the West Mumbai on the west coast of India. It is a natural deep water harbor. Mumbai port is the largest port in India. It handles a bulk cargo traffic with its four jetties for handling liquid chemicals, crude and petroleum products. Murmagao port, Goa. The main port of Goa is Murmagao port, and it is the best natural harbor of India, located in South Goa. Murmagao port is one of the leading iron ore exporters port in India. The major attractions of Goa is this port that is situated along a beautiful city of Vasco da Gama and the International Airport Dublin. The natural harbor of Goa is India's most modern ports in today's time. Mangalore Port, Karnataka. The first name of Mangalore Port is Panambur Port. The seaport located near to the Suratkar railway station in Dakshina Kannada district of Karnataka. New Mangalore Port is a deep water all weather port and only a major port of Karnataka and one of the largest ports in India. The exports of commodities like manganese, granite, stones, coffees and cashews, and the main import includes timber, logs, LPG, petroleum products and cargo containers. Cochin Port, Kerala. The major port of the Arabian and the Indian Ocean sea route. The port of Cochin lies on the two islands of Willingdon and Vallarpadam. The largest container transshipment facility in India. Cochin city is famous for its traditional spices. Well known as the port city of Fort Kochi during the European colonies. Port Blair, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Andaman and Nicobar Islands are union territory of India located at the juncture of the Bay of Bengal and Andaman Sea. The Port Blair is the youngest sea in India and one of the 13 major ports of the country. Port Blair is the principal hub of shipping in the islands of Andaman. One of the most popular tourist destinations with several places of interest around like virgin beaches, scuba diving and water sports. Tuticorin Port, Tamil Nadu. Tuticorin is an artificial deep sea harbor and one of the 13 major ports of India. It is also the second largest port in Tamil Nadu. The first largest is known as the Chennai port. The artificial port of Tuticorin is an all-weather port who receives a large volume of international traffic. Tuticorin ports are used to be the best port of maritime trade and the pearl fishery on the Bay of Bengal. Chennai port. The old name of Chennai port was the Madras port. It is the second largest port of the country and the first largest in its state. Hub port of cars, big containers and cargo traffic in the east coast of India. It handles a variety of cargo containers of automobiles, coal, fertilizers, petroleum products and many other things. Chennai port terminals have lighthouses around, intra-port connectivity pipelines and heavy railway terminals. Visakhapatnam Port, Andhra Pradesh. Port city Visakhapatnam is located on the southeast coast of India in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Also known as Vizag. It has the one of the India's largest seaport and the oldest shipyard of the country. It is the only natural harbor in the Bay of Bengal shore. Coal is manually loaded and unloaded from vessels and shoveled on the trucks to take it on open stack yard from where winds carry coal dust to the city. Paradip Port, Odisha. The artificial deep water port situated in the Jagatsinghpur district of Odisha state. The port of Paradip is the major port in the east coast shore. Paradip has its own railway system, coal handling plant and natural highway connects the port with the rest of the Indian road networks. Haldia Port, West Bengal. Also known as the Calcutta port. It is a major seaport situated near the Hooghly River in the state of West Bengal. Port of Haldia is one of the major trade centers of Calcutta. It receives a bulk cargo of chemicals, petrochemicals and oils. The port of Kolkata is also the base of Indian Coast Guards. Kollam Port, Kerala. It is situated 4 kilometers away from the city of Kollam, the cashew capital of the world. It is the second largest port in Kerala by volume of cargo handled and facility. The port is governed by the Directorate of Port Departments of the Government of Kerala. So here I would like to end my today's introduction topic. Hope every one of you have enjoyed this session. Thank you. Thank you very much.